Hey YouTube, it's Miss PYT09 and I'm coming at you today with a vanity tour. Okay, so let's go ahead and jump right in. What you see here is my vanity that I created on a budget of $100. All the accessories that you see on top of my vanity, I created using Dollar Tree products. Some of the things I bought and some of the things that I use to do DIY projects for the vanity. Okay, so the table I purchased from Walmart for $39.98, and it's just an ebony black mainstay writing desk, and it comes with a drawer. The drawer isn't very deep, but it is just the right size to house some makeup. Okay, the chair I did not include in my budget because it's an chair that I previously owned. It's actually a dinette chair in which I just decided to use it at my vanity. It was previously black, but I decided to go ahead and spray paint it silver. Their chair pad is a pad that I already owned, and I'm going to eventually get rid of this chair pad and replace it with a plum purple chair pad. Okay, so let's move right along. So the mirror is a mirror that I created using Dollar Tree lights, but I purchased the black mirror itself from Walmart for $10, and it's just a basic mirror with a black plastic framing. And the lights are 6 lights that I purchased from the Dollar Tree, and they are the LED lights. And they're battery operated, and I just purchased 6 of them, and they were $1 each, and they run off of 3 AAA batteries. Okay, so here's a close-up of the lights, and they're fairly bright, and I just left this one off so that I could show you guys what it actually looks like when it's not lit, and you just touch it, and it lights up. Okay, so around the mirror, I chose to purchase some string lights. And I purchased those string lights from Dollar Tree as well. And I got purchased 2 pair of lights. And those are battery operated as well. And I just chose to hang the lights up with clear thumbtacks. And down here is the battery pack, the actual battery pack where you control the lights. And so you just flip the little switch here at the top and you can turn them off and on. And it takes 2 AA batteries. So that's how I control those lights. And I'm just going to hook this back on the little thumbtack, guys, if it'll cooperate with me. Okay, so moving right along, the decal at the top of the picture, I mean, at the top of the mirror, it says, "Trust in the Lord with all of my heart." And it's just one of those little self-adhesive decals. And I purchased this decal at Walmart for $1. But they also have these decals at the Dollar Tree now. And they have various sayings on them. So let's go ahead and move right along. Oh, before I move along, let me say something about the lights. The lights are actually self-adhesive. They come with a self-adhesive backing on them, but I chose to take that adhesive off, and I chose to use the 3M Velcro strips for the lights because the backing was not strong enough to hold up on the plastic mirror, and so they kept on falling off. But if you are to use this on the actual wall, it is very sturdy. So that's just a little bit of information for anybody that would like to purchase those lights. Okay, so let's go ahead and let's move along to the accessories on my vanity. And this is just an overall look before we get started. And I'm gonna go ahead and start down here with this little candle right here. I purchased this little candle at the Dollar Tree as well. And it was just $1 like everything else at Dollar Tree. And I just thought it was so dainty and so cute, y'all. And it smells really, really good. It smells like vanilla. So I just wanted to pick that up because I thought it would add a lot of character to my vanity. And I just love, love, love cupcakes. So I got that. And then I got this little square candle holder, in which it's a candle holder, but I chose to use it as a makeup brush holder instead. So I'm using that to put my bigger makeup brushes in. Next, this is my palette holder, but these are not actually palette holders. They are actually three napkin holders that I found at the Dollar Tree in the kitchen area. So I decided to glue three of those napkin holders together, and I'm using it to just hold my palette. So I have some Wet n Wild palettes here, some eyeshadow palettes in there. And then I have my Urban Decay palette, and I can put so many more palettes in there. So that's what I decided to use as a palette holder. And the only thing that I did to it was I glued them all together using E6000, and I went ahead and spray painted the front black, because this is actually just clear. So I spray painted it black. Okay, the next item that I purchased was this really cute flower shape makeup brush holder, and it is made out of really good acrylic, y'all. So it's not really like a cheap plastic or anything, but it's an actual hard plastic. And in the bigger holes, you can actually put your bigger brushes in, and then in the center it has like a little small part where you can actually stick your smaller eye brush makeup brushes in, which I have these two sitting here because these are two brushes that I use every day to do my eyebrows. Okay, and so let me go ahead and show you guys the box that came in. So if you want to go ahead and purchase this from the Dollar Tree, and it says flower shape cosmetic organizer, and that's what it looks like. So you can't beat paying a dollar for this. And it just says this flower shape cosmetic organizer is perfect for keeping your brushes, makeup tools, and cosmetic organizer, and easy to find. Compact size with 7 compartments for storage, clear, elegant, fun flower shape design. Okay, so that's that. Okay, so back here in the back is some other makeup brush holders that I got from the Dollar Tree, but actually I just bought the items individually and I glued them all together with E6000. So this was a DIY project using Dollar Tree materials. I just bought the little candle, the top piece, the candle holder from the candle aisle, and I got the little mirror base, because it's actually a mirror, and I got that from the candle aisle. And then I got the actual candlestick holder from the candle aisle as well. And then I just glued those all together, and then I added some bling wrap from the Dollar Tree around the top of the vase. And then to get my makeup brushes to stand up in there like they are, I just added some of these white pebbled rocks vase fillers that I got from the Dollar Tree as well. So all those items can be located at the Dollar Tree as well. So I'm just gonna stand these bad boys back up, y'all. Okay, so I made a second one, which you can see is taller than the first one I showed you, and I just used two of the candlestick holders, and I just turned them upside down and glued those together. So I got one for my small eye brushes, and then I got one for my bigger face brushes. Okay, so we're gonna skip right all over to this right here. This is a old Bath and Body Works candle that I just cleaned out and repurposed. And so I just depotted the candle. I cleaned it out with soap and water and vinegar. I took the labels off and cleaned it really good. And then I went to my local hardware store, the Home Depot, and I purchased this knob that's on the top in the cabinet aisle. Where so this it's just like a cabinet knob, basically. And I just glued it on using some E6000 glue. And I'm just housing my Q-tips in there. So isn't that cute? I thought so. So that is that. But I also made a second one, which is over here on my dresser, because I ran out of room. And the only thing that I did different to this one was I actually added one of the Dollar Tree candlesticks to the bottom. I glued it to the bottom of the Bath & Body Works jar. And this one houses my little flat facial pads. And like I said, I did the same. Excuse me, y'all. I did the same thing. I just added a knob on the top. And those knobs, well, you can purchase these knobs at Home Depot for $4 a piece. And they have various other types of knobs as well. Okay, so the next thing that I found for my vanity that I really, really like is this little trinket tray. And it just says love yourself on it. And how cute is this, y'all? I just love this. It's so pretty. And I just keep some of my little stud earrings on there. And I paid a dollar for that as well at the Dollar Tree. I went to the school supply area and I found this little bag, this wire mesh basket. And I just use it to hold my beauty blenders, and they're dirty and I need to wash them. And so that's what I use to hold my makeup brushes, my makeup sponges and beauty blenders. Okay, so this right here. Now, this I did not purchase at the Dollar Tree. And I did not include this in my $100 budget because I already own this. So this is just one of these little light up standalone Conair brand makeup mirrors. And it does light up. And I just turn it on. It's battery operated. And it is dual sided and has a regular side and a magnifying side. So I paid $20 for this 2 years ago on Amazon. So if anybody was wanting to know, I got it off of Amazon. Okay, so that's that. And then the last three things that I have on my vanity are the makeup organizers that I purchased from the Dollar Tree individually. And this is just a lipstick holder. Or you can put lip glosses in there. And this particular one, I'm holding my lip glosses. And it is tiered, so it gradually goes up so that your lip glosses can be displayed. And then I also have one back here in which I just chose to display my nail polishes. So you not only can you use them for lipsticks and lip glosses, but you can use them for nail polishes as well. And then the one in the very back there, I have some lipsticks that I own. And then in the very back of this one, it's made a little bit different. It just has a flat base with no dividers. And I just have some sample size body washes and lotions and some hand soap back there that I was just displaying on my vanity. And I did not glue these together. I actually just have them separate. But if you would like to glue them together and decorate them, that's an awesome idea as well. Okay, so that's the top of my vanity. Oh, I almost forgot about this. Let me come back around here to this. This is another DIY project that I created using Dollar Tree faux acrylic storage. And I call these faux acrylic because these are not actually acrylic. These are a plastic material, but they're still a good quality. Okay, so the drawers actually don't come stacked up like this. I actually glued the individual drawers together. And so this is just one unit here and so on. And I just glued them together with E6000 glue. And I added these little cute little jewel rhinestones on them here on the corners and right here on the actual drawer pull itself. And then on the top, I found this other organizer that basically has like different little compartments and stuff. So I'll just go through here really quickly about what I have in here. So I have some of my face powders in the bottom drawer. I have another face powder. I have two eyeshadow pot palettes in this drawer. And then in the top drawer, I have some blushes and some eyeshadow primers. Okay, and then in the very top one up here, I have some Origins facial mask. I have a lip balm, some hand cream. I have my Stay Matte Rimmel face primer. I have some lip glosses, some NYX lip glosses, and then I have in the behind here is another slot, and it does go up, gradually go up, and I just have some of my favorite NYX lingerie lip glosses. And then behind that, I have some Milani lip gloss. And then I have, in the very back, is big enough to hold some of your foundation. So I got some foundations back there. And then on the side, it's kind of curved right here. And I just stuck some of my liquid eyeliners and some of my regular eyeliners back there. So that's what I have storing some of my makeup pieces there as well. And so I got this DIY idea from a young lady here on YouTube. Her name is April, and her channel is MsMuffinismyLover, and I'll include her video link in the description bar. Now back to the makeup brush holders. I got that from a lady here on YouTube as well, and I will include her link down in the description box as well. So if you guys want to check out their videos, then you can go ahead and go right on over. Okay, so the last part of the actual vanity is the drawer. And this is the drawer, you guys. And it just has enough room to hold. I have two long containers, and I have two big containers. I have one right behind this one. And I got the containers from Walmart. And they're actually this teal color, which I tried to spray paint them. And as you can see, it did not work out. But yeah, so you get 8 of those containers, and they're $5. And so I just have some of my makeup products in here, and I have some mascaras there, some lip liners, my tiger grass cream for redness, my eyebrow pencil with spoolie, some elf eyebrow gel in there, and then over here I have some eyelashes and eyelash glue, some dental floss. I have some makeup wipes, and then the tray behind it, I don't really have anything in there but some lip glosses. And then the drawer itself actually comes in a tannish wood, natural wood color, but I just opted to go ahead and spray paint it black because I did not like the wood color itself. And then this little white and black floral print here, this is just actually one of those drawer mats, drawer liners that you can get from the Dollar Tree. So I picked up a roll of that, and I just stuck it in the bottom just to keep the bottom of the drawer clean. And that's it. So that's the drawer. And then over here is just the bottom here. I just have a wire mesh basket that I picked up from the Dollar Tree for $1. And I just use this for like throw my dirty makeup wipes and stuff in, or empty out, you know, makeup packages and stuff. And then down here I have my, I have some extra storage, like some of these extra storage containers down here. And as well as I have some extra string lights and batteries and things to go around my vanity down there. And that's that. So the last two items of my beauty desk area is this little area here, which I don't have any makeup in it, but I will show you guys what I do have in there. I am a newbie at makeup, so I don't have like a huge collection yet. So as my collection expands, then I will go ahead and fill these drawers up with makeup. Okay, so I'm just gonna go ahead and show you really fast what I have in the drawers, and then I'll talk about the piece on top. So what I have here are these little black containers, which I purchased from the Dollar Tree itself. And I just have some facial masks in them. And I have some, this basket in the back, I just house like my little press on nails and stuff. And I got some nail glue in there. So that's my nail basket. And this one is for face masks. And those two don't have anything. And so, and I have a cloth here to wipe my makeup brushes off in between doing eyeshadow. And I just have some extra cotton balls and Q-tips. and some of the extra facial pads to fill up my drawers. Nothing special, you guys. Okay, in the bottom drawer, I just have like hair related stuff down here. I have like some hair ties, and I have some pipe cleaners to roll my hair on, and some combs and brushes. And what is this? Oh, this is like some hair gel. And that's it. So I didn't include this little three drawer cart in my budget as well because I already owned it. So I would recommend, before you go out and buy anything, look around your house and see what you can repurpose to use for your beauty space. And also, this has wheels on it, so I can actually move it around. So that's that. Okay, so the last thing that I want to show you guys is this little DIY project that I did, and it's a Lazy Susan that I created using Dollar Tree products. And I just purchased three different shape trays, like serving platters, from the Dollar Tree and the Party Owl. And I purchased two of these crystal candlestick holders, which I turned upside down to give me more room on the tray. And I just glued it all together using the E6000 glue. And I'm using this to house like my jewelry pieces that I just want to display, like watches and bracelets and earrings and such. But you can also display like your perfumes on here, your nail polishes, like maybe some of your big MAC makeup collectors pieces and stuff. You know, I know MAC always have like the different collector pieces that come out and stuff. So you might want to house those collector items over here on this here. So I actually got this idea from a young lady here on YouTube as well, and I will find her video and I will leave the link down in my description box as well. So you guys, that's the end of my tour, and I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I hope it wasn't too long. I tried to make things as simple as possible, but I also wanted to give you a little bit of details of where you could find everything. And yeah, so don't forget to thumbs this video up, you guys. And if you like this video, I can also create some other videos of projects and stuff that things that I created using Dollar Tree products as well. So don't forget to thumbs this video up and go ahead and subscribe if you haven't already subscribed. And for the ones that are already subscribed, thank you for supporting my channel. I love you guys. You are the greatest. If you have any requests for videos, go ahead and leave those down in the comment box. And I will talk to you guys later.